out an EP of tracks I wrote in that period, in the last year or two particularly, that I'm doing with Microcastle. It's going to be called Sunbreak, or possibly Sunbreak the Shell. There's some discussion on the name of the EP. And it's really quite personal stuff. I wasn't particularly even bothered about turning into dance music. One of them is a beatless track, because I sort of thought that the logical end of this whole process, this thing of trying not to care about what's currently trendy or what's meant to work, was just to release some of this stuff and say, you know what, these are things I've made, and if people get off on them, that's great. If they don't, it's, you know, it's a shame, but it's really mainly made for me. So that's the essence of that release, really. I mean, there's a track on there that's, I mean, there's nothing worse than somebody sitting around saying, this tune's so personal to me. So I'm sorry, but that one of the tunes is so personal to me. Because it's sadly, it's true in this case. It was literally written in a night, in 3 hours, on this and this, just to get something I wasn't able to say or do at the time particularly usefully, but I just had to get it out somewhere. And so I just sort of sat here and thought, you know what, I'm just going to do something exactly how people like Brian Eno, who's a massive inspiration to me, used to make the tunes I really loved from the 70s. They'd just play by hand. They actually wouldn't even write them before they started. They'd just start recording and see what came out. And so I just sat here with no sequencer particularly and just recorded me playing stuff, layered it up, treated it and finished it, and it was done. And I absolutely love it. It's one of the best things I've ever made. I'm very rarely given to pat myself on the back, but for me personally, it's one of the best things I've ever made. I'm very happy that, you know, I've actually got that out of me. Oh, to be you, to be me, and to see what you see in this. That is what that EP is about and for. And there's also one other piece of unfinished business on there, which is that I had a track in 2001 called Black AM. And that this was during the You're Gonna Be a Massive Star Son phase. And it got signed to Sony for a large chunk of cash. The girl who sang the song, a girl called Natalie Arnold, was, you know, being like prepped for like how to dance on Top of the Pops. It was, you know, ridiculous amount of fuss and buzz about this record. Take me up to the second floor. I know you've been... So we made a follow-up. And again, I sort of had this and thought, I just don't know if it's the time, people aren't playing vocals. It was that, you know, minimal techno thing when, you know, putting a vocal on a record is pretty much just like, I don't know, smearing it with cheese and saying, this is terrible, don't play it. So I had this tune I wanted to make, but there was no outlet for. And so that, I finally realised now, is the time. So I finished that, made it into a track that I'm pleased with. And that's on there too. So it's just a sort of a culmination of stuff that was important to me that I did without a rush to release or a rush or a deadline or a label ready to take it. So that's what this EP is. If you like it, then good, because I like what's on it quite a lot.